Hello, my dear students. How are you? I hope you are all fine. Our session today about energy, Unit 9. We are going to study Unit 9 about energy. We have just finished Unit 8, as you know, the difference between physical and chemical change. Now we are going to study energy. Lesson 1 is about forms of energy. But first of all, do you know what's meant by energy? What's meant by energy? Do you know energy? What does it mean? Energy means the ability to do work, the ability to make a change. For example, if you are able to make work, so you have energy. If you are able to push a chair, if you are able to open the door, if you are able to carry something, if you are able to put something, so if you are able to do any work, so you have energy. So energy means the ability to cause a change in matter. The ability to cause a change in matter, or the ability to do work. The ability to do work. For example, everything that moves has energy. Everything that moves has energy. For example, people, animal get their energy from what? We get our energy from what? From food that we eat. Animals also get their energy from what? From the food that they eat. Even cars get the energy from gasoline. You know the gasoline? Yes, the liquid fuel which causes the car to move on. Yes, gasoline gives the car energy to move. So now we are gonna study the different forms of energy. Energy have many different forms, have different many types. Like what? First of them is kinetic energy. Again, kinetic energy. What does it mean, kinetic energy? Here is the first form of energy, or the first example of the forms of energy, which is known as kinetic energy. Kinetic energy is the energy of motion. The energy of motion. So if you are moving, if an animal is moving, if anything is moving, its energy is called kinetic energy. Again, kinetic energy is the energy of motion. Motion. If you are running, if you are walking, if you are moving, you have an energy called kinetic energy. Here is the first one. So the running boy in this picture has kinetic energy. Okay? The second one is called potential energy. Actually, potential energy is the opposite of kinetic energy. If you are moving, then you have kinetic energy. But if you are standing in your position, if you are in your position, if you don't move, if you are not moving anywhere, so you are storing an energy inside of you, is called potential energy. So the potential energy is the energy something has because of its position. Again, potential energy is the energy something has because of its position. Something or someone, of course, okay? So if you are sitting, if you are standing, doing nothing, not moving, you are storing an energy inside of you, which is called potential energy. For example, do you know the roller coaster cars? Do you know it? At the top of this hill, at the top of this hill, the cars still standing there, not moving, they are storing energy inside of them, which is called potential energy. When they start to slide down, this potential energy changes to kinetic energy. So when they are moving, they have kinetic energy. But when they are standing up at the top of the hill, it's potential energy. So the roller coaster car at the top of the hill has potential energy. So the potential energy is the difference of the opposite of kinetic energy. Kinetic energy, again, is the energy of motion, while potential energy is the energy of something or someone has because of its position. Stable like this. Another kind of energy which is called mechanical energy. Actually, mechanical energy is a summation or the adding of both kinetic and potential energy. Mechanical energy is the total potential energy and kinetic energy of an object. If you have both potential energy and then you're moving, doing a kinetic energy, both of them together, the summation of both of them together is called mechanical energy. So the mechanical energy of a moving roller coaster, for example, in this situation or in this picture, is the sum of the potential energy and its kinetic energy. Again, the mechanical energy of the moving roller coaster car in this picture is the sum of its potential energy and kinetic energy. Why? Because simply mechanical energy equals kinetic energy plus potential energy, both of them together. So both of kinetic energy and potential energy together is called mechanical energy. So now we have kinetic energy, potential energy, and the summation of both of them, which is mechanical energy. What other kinds of forms of energy? Let's see. Chemical energy. Chemical energy means the energy that can be released by a chemical change. Do you remember the chemical change we have started before in unit 8? Chemical change like what? We have studied many examples, we've took many examples. Yes, burning of wood, for example. Burning of wood is a chemical change. So the energy releasing from the burning of wood is considered a chemical energy. Again, the energy which is releasing from burning of wood is called chemical energy. Not only burning of wood. We have studied before another example, by the way, for the chemical change, which is eating food. Eating food, burning of food inside our bodies. Burning of food inside our bodies is a chemical or physical change? Chemical change, of course. Chemical change, as we studied before. So the chemical energy also in food gives you energy. Chemical energy in food gives you energy. Since digestion of food or burning of food inside our bodies also is a chemical change, so the energy coming from chemical change is called chemical energy. Okay? We are going to continue the other forms of energy in next time. Bye bye. See you.